While the explosions often get the spotlight in news reports, the real hurdles for Starship Flight 10 are found in a variety of areas. Significant concerns have emerged on the launch pad regarding the quick disconnect mechanism that is essential for refueling and connecting the boosters. Any setbacks in this area could result in delays for the next flight. What happened? What are the implications? And how will SpaceX respond? Let's dive deeper on today's episode of NR Studio. After the thrilling flight and Elon Musk's revelation that the next Starship launch could potentially happen in just 3 to 4 weeks has sparked considerable excitement across the board. However, turning that hopeful timeline into a reality involves overcoming some significant challenges. While the Federal Aviation Administration has resolved the booster issues associated with Flight 9, a new issue has now emerged. Recent findings have revealed debris from the boosters. This new development could substantially increase the workload for SpaceX. Additionally, the spacecraft segment, commonly known as the Starship, is currently undergoing extensive inspection, which could cause further delays in its development. However, there is one aspect that has not received much attention from everyone. The launch pad, usually an overlooked component, faces significant challenges. In recent flights, improvements made to the launch pad have proven so effective that many believe the launch pad is no longer an issue. It is important to examine this situation more thoroughly. Recent images have revealed that the booster quick disconnect, considered one of the most delicate and fragile components of the Starship launch pad, was damaged during the last launch. The QD showed significant signs of scorch, visible not only on its outer surface, but also extending deep into its internal components. Certain areas showed signs of damage, with the edges and joints of the shell appearing partially broken and showing a melted appearance. If a robust system like the QD is susceptible to damage, it stands to reason that more fragile infrastructure, such as fuel pipes and small ground connections that may be located at greater distances, could also be adversely affected. During the flight, there were indications that the fuel lines may have been damaged by the tremendous forces experienced during launch. What caused this latest damage? Reflecting on the launch, the engine burn lasted about 15 seconds, after which the energy plume completely disappeared from the launch pad. During this period, the launch pad, and especially the QD booster, is subjected to extreme levels of heat, pressure, and acoustic energy generated by the collective power of 33 Raptor engines. This unprecedented combination produces the most powerful rocket thrust ever recorded in history. The QD booster is especially vulnerable, as it is positioned directly below the Super Heavy booster and remains physically connected to it until launch. As the launch clamps are pulled back and the rocket begins to rise, the quick disconnect QD system is required to simultaneously disconnect all fuel and electrical connections while safely closing them. This action is essential to maintaining the safety of its internal systems during the launch phase. It is possible that the QD did not close quickly enough during the final flight. The timing mechanism, which is responsible for synchronizing the retraction of the internal systems with the closing of the protective shell, may not have effectively protected the internal components. This phenomenon could explain the distortion and slight melting currently observed along the edges and seams. Even when operating optimally, the QD shell has limitations. Its purpose is to withstand significant forces for short durations. However, under such intense pressure, durability is an elusive concept. Even a small hole in the shell can allow high-velocity energy and heat to leak through, potentially damaging fragile internal systems. Now, with clear indications of damage, SpaceX may be facing the need for significant upgrades or even complete replacement of various components. As a result, this situation will have implications for future flights. The launch pad plays a critical role in a crucial phase known as the static firing test. The test cannot proceed without an operational QD system. The upcoming booster, designated B-16, has successfully completed its cryogenic testing phase and is anticipated to be equipped with engines. This positions it to be ready for the static firing test. However, without a solid foundation for launch, B-16 remains stuck in place. Each delay magnifies the next delay. As we look ahead, these types of challenges could increase the risks associated with future launches. Failure to fully repair damage to the QD system could compromise a launch procedure or, in a more severe scenario, cause a catastrophic failure. Even under optimal circumstances, significant damage would require a longer repair period between launches, hampering SpaceX's ambitious development goals. The pressing question is whether the QD thruster issue will result in a delay for Flight 10. SpaceX has built a reputation for its ability to overcome challenges with incredible speed. However, with the deadline looming, the pressure is on. It's clear that while the skies offer limitless potential, terrestrial infrastructure, specifically the launch pad, plays a critical role in the overall equation. What do you think? Do you believe the QD thruster situation will delay any upcoming launches? Please share your answers with a simple yes or no in the comments below. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates as we explore SpaceX's incredible mission to the moon and beyond. This brings us to the importance of Launch Pad B, a critical advancement in SpaceX's long-term infrastructure and strategic vision. It's becoming increasingly clear that simply repairing or replacing damaged components after each flight is not a viable long-term strategy. For Starship to achieve frequent and reliable flights, SpaceX needs to shift its focus from reactive maintenance to developing a more resilient, future-proof design. That's what's being done with Pad B. Unlike A, Pad B introduces a groundbreaking transformation. The launch pad has evolved from a single static structure that integrated the orbital launch cradle and the booster's quick disconnect. Rather than maintaining a unified structure, the system has been dismantled and restructured into standalone components. The OLM that recently launched on Pad B is a modular mobile platform. The assembly consists only of the retaining clamp arm, which has now been equipped with an improved opening and closing mechanism. This enhancement was specifically designed to protect the fragile component during liftoff. The modification significantly improves the system's durability and maintainability. Meanwhile, the QD booster has been completely removed from the OLM and has been developed as a standalone structure. Housed within a striking triangular steel structure known as the BQD gantry, the installation is located adjacent to the fire trench. In the latest development, SpaceX successfully installed a new quick disconnect QD cover, marking a significant milestone as the QD system now operates independently of the launch platform. This newly introduced configuration offers several important benefits. By increasing the physical separation between the booster QD and the primary OLM, along with an improved retraction mechanism, the system is better equipped to withstand the intense forces encountered during a launch or test scenario. This implies a reduced chance of damage, an expedited post-flight repair process, and minimal disruption to other operations on the launch pad. The benefits are further enhanced by the incorporation of a fire trench. This trench channels heat and pressure away from the pad and its most fragile systems, preventing a dangerous buildup of energy. This is critical to protecting the booster QD, which was damaged during Flight 9 due to severe thermal and acoustic stress. This improvement marks a significant step forward in the development of the launch infrastructure for the future of Starship. In fact, a similar design is currently being implemented at SpaceX Florida facility. The upcoming launch pad, anticipated to be operational by the end of the year, is designed to facilitate an ambitious launch schedule that could see as many as launch as of each year. In addition, it is scheduled to manage critical NASA missions such as Starship flights aimed at the Artemis lunar landings. The development of the site is taking place in conjunction with the construction of other critical facilities, including the new Gigafactory. The upcoming facility is expected to surpass the capabilities of the existing megabase. The result will be a comprehensive ecosystem designed for efficient and reliable Starship production and launches, characterized by vertical integration. At Starbase, preparations are underway for Pad B to transition operations from Pad A in the near future. According to recent reports, Pad A is expected to host several additional flights before being temporarily closed for significant upgrades. These upgrades will involve the development of fire trenches and the full integration of systems designed similarly to those used at Pad B. Among these options, the QD booster is anticipated to attract significant attention, especially given the recent damage. The ongoing upgrade efforts at Pad A could continue into next year. This all points to a clear and ambitious vision. SpaceX is preparing for a future of high-frequency, sustained operations with its Starship program. The future will require a launch infrastructure that can facilitate fast turnaround times, which can only be achieved through the implementation of robust and easy-to-maintain systems. This is not just rhetoric. Musk has indicated that, in the future, Super Heavy boosters could launch every hour, while Starship could launch every day. President Gwynne Shadwell has estimated that there will be as many as 200 Starship flights scheduled from 2025 to 2028. Musk has expressed an ambitious goal of up to 10 launches per day during each Mars transfer window, setting a breakneck pace for space exploration. In the coming years, particularly by 2026, a significant jump in launch frequency is anticipated. The implementation of the Starship refueling system will require a series of Starship tankers operating in a coordinated sequence to provide fuel for a single main Starship en route to the Moon or Mars. The increase will not just focus on quantity. SpaceX is significantly increasing its energy capacity. Currently, the Starship program uses the V1 and V2 variants of the Super Heavy booster and spacecraft. However, indications are emerging that the next phase of development, known as Version 3, is on the horizon. The enhanced version of Starship will be equipped with advanced Raptor 3 engines, which will significantly increase thrust and overall performance. As hardware capabilities continue to evolve, it is critical that ground systems evolve in tandem. With Pad B at the forefront and Pad A close behind, SpaceX is laying a solid foundation for the future of interplanetary travel. This is not just an upgrade, it is a complete transformation. Before SpaceX can fully realize its ambitious vision for the future of spaceflight, it must first address the pressing challenges that lie ahead. At the top of the agenda is the urgent requirement to address issues associated with the A launch pad, specifically damage sustained during the booster's quick disconnect. For SpaceX to maintain its ambitious schedule and secure a June launch, it is critical that the A-pad's repairs are completed by the first week of the month. Meeting this tight deadline is critical to preparing the site to house prototype vehicles, facilitate critical testing, and quickly advance through the next phases of the launch campaign. However, difficulties remain after the 10th flight. Musk has indicated that the next three launches are expected to occur at a rate of about one every 3 to 4 weeks. This rapid momentum is likely to put significant stress on the aging infrastructure at Pad A, which has yet to receive a major upgrade. The FAA has authorized a maximum of 25 Starship launches from Starbase, but achieving this target will likely test the capabilities of Pad A, especially given its current condition. At the same time, Pad B must be completed and ready for operation at the earliest opportunity. Completion of the installation phase is critical to facilitate comprehensive system testing and validation. If SpaceX can successfully activate Pad B before Pad A is temporarily closed for repairs, it will ensure a smooth continuation of the Starship development process. It is likely that we will see both pads operating simultaneously in the near future. Pad B could play a critical role in critical missions, including early attempts to capture both stages during their flights. Achieving this would be a major milestone in the quest for full system reuse. On the vehicle side, future missions are set to address significant technical objectives. These involve executing untested maneuvers, overcoming issues encountered on previous flights, and demonstrating increasingly complex flight profiles. Each significant milestone will lay the groundwork for more significant accomplishments, including retrieving returning spacecraft, achieving complete reusability, and establishing the propellant transfer infrastructure necessary for missions to the Moon and beyond. There's no doubt that the future of the Starship program is fraught with obstacles. Challenges can arise from unexpected sources, such as the QD booster. While setbacks can derail progress, they also serve as significant reminders. In a landscape of fast-moving technological advancement, it's critical for SpaceX to remain vigilant, maintain a systematic approach, and focus intently on the details. The incident involving the QD booster is just one illustration of a broader issue. A solitary element in the vast and complex Starship launch system, it highlights a deeper reality. To succeed in its pursuit of space exploration, SpaceX must continually improve, evolve, and adapt its strategy. While there's no denying that this is a significant challenge, it's certainly within the realm of possibility. Attention now turns to how SpaceX will navigate these early challenges on its path to its 10th flight. The upcoming Pad A test will serve as a critical testing ground, not only for the hardware itself, but also for the company's capacity to sustain progress despite challenges. Driven by unwavering determination, cutting-edge innovation, and an insatiable drive, SpaceX is committed to advancing its mission, meticulously advancing with each launch. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.